So why do you risk your life to raise your voice?
Because I thought that my people need me, and I shall raise my voice because if I didn't raise my voice now, so when will I raise my voice?
Some people might say you're 14. You don't have any rights. You just have to listen to mom and dad.
No, I have rights. I have the right of education. I have the right to play. I have the right to sing. I have the right to talk. I have the right to go to market. I have the right to speak up.
Well, what if you give that advice to a girl who may not be as courageous as you, and she says, Malala, I'm afraid. I just want to stay in my room.
So I'll tell her that don't stay in your room, because God will ask you on the day of judgment that where were you when your people were asking you, when your school fellows were asking you, and when your school was asking you that I am being blown up. When your people need you, you should come up, you should come, and you should stand up for their rights.
If you were the president of this country, how would you handle the Taliban?
First of all, I would like to build so many schools in this country, because education is the must thing. If you don't have educated people, so the Taliban will come to your area. But if you have educated people, they will not come.
Well, educated or not, the Taliban come with bombs and guns. How do you handle that? I mean, do you still talk to them, or do you call in the army? What do you do?
First of all, I would like to talk to them.
What would you say?
I would say that, what are your demands? What do you want?
We want you to shut down the school, is what they'd say.
So I'll tell them that don't shut our schools, because school, I will...
You're 14. You have no idea what you're talking about. We're going to shut down your school.
So, give me a second. So first of all, I will show them Quran, what Quran says. Quran didn't say that girls are not allowed to go to school.